This video was made possible by Wix. If you're ready to create a website, head over to wix.com/go/infographics to try out one of their premium plans right now. The biggest great white shark ever discovered and reliably measured was a 20-foot-long, 7,330-pound shark found off the waters of Cuba in 1945. Yet, even larger sharks have been reportedly caught. One in South Australia in 1870 measured 36 feet and another measuring 37 feet. Though both have been dismissed by biologists due to the sheer size, claiming it's impossible great whites could grow that big. Yet, what if those sharks caught were real, and not just fish stories? And what if they weren't necessarily great whites? Hello and welcome to another special episode of the Infographics Show's Greatest Mysteries. Today, we're taking a look at the Megalodon shark and asking the question, does it still live? Most scientists believe the Megalodon went extinct about 2 million years ago, and that's good news for anybody who enjoys taking dips in the ocean, as these monsters grew to sizes up to 59 feet in length and sported teeth 7 inches long. As the largest predatory fish to have ever lived, the Megalodon fed on a variety of prey. But its preferred prey was without a doubt whales. By examining the remains of fossilized whale skeletons that bear the scars of a Megalodon attack, scientists have been able to learn a lot about its hunting strategies. While a great white prefers to ambush prey with a single bite and then let it bleed out, the Megalodon would attack the tough, bony portions of its prey such as shoulders, flippers, ribcage, and upper spine, crushing bone and rupturing organs. A single bite to a whale's backbone could paralyze the animal, leaving the Megalodon to feed at its leisure. And with a bite force between 24,400 and 41,000 pounds, crushing tough whale bones would have been a simple task for a giant shark. But Megalodons didn't just eat whales. As opportunistic hunters, they would prey on seals, sea lions, dolphins, and generally anything smaller than itself, which made nearly the entire ocean fair game. Paleontologists have even discovered the shattered shells of giant sea turtles bearing the telltale scars of a Megalodon attack. For decades, scientists have assumed that Megalodon died out toward the start of the latest ice age, theorizing that because, like modern sharks, it was unable to regulate its body temperature, cooling waters eventually led to extinction. Yet, a 2016 study showed that there seemed to be no correlation between climate change and Megalodon's decline, instead linking the giant shark's extinction to the rise of smaller, more agile predators and the decline of large prey, such as filter-feeding whales, which began dying off around the same time. This new discovery has been groundbreaking for believers in Megalodon's continued survival. As mainstream science has long held that because Megalodon lived exclusively in warm waters, that it could not have survived through the ice age like the great white did, which frequents cold waters. If cooling climate didn't cause the Megalodon to go extinct though, could a small, relic population have retreated to deeper waters in search of large enough prey to sustain it? This is the most commonly held theory on Megalodon's continued survival, with proponents pointing at recent discoveries in great white behavior that showed the sharks regularly dive to very deep depths in search of food. With giant squid thought to grow up to 43 feet, Megalodon may have found a suitable prey in the deepest depths. If forced to hunt large squid, it would explain why Megalodon is unknown to science. The first live giant squid ever filmed was only caught as recently as 2012, and with a tiny fraction of the oceans explored by mankind, there's no telling what else is out there. Proponents for the Megalodon's survival also point at the recent discoveries of other fish thought to be extinct for millions of years, such as the Megamouth shark. Discovered alive and well in 1976, a bizarre-looking fish was thought extinct for a whopping 65 million years until one was fished up in 1938. So could a Megalodon still be alive somewhere in the deepest oceans today? Is there any evidence? In 1875, the HMS Challenger, out on a deep-sea expedition, dredged up a pair of Megalodon teeth, which were later dated as being 10,000 to 15,000 years old. This moves the date up for the last living Megalodon to just before the start of human civilization. And if one Megalodon survived past the Ice Age, then it's not a stretch for the imagination to believe that others did too, and may continue to thrive in the deepest depths. Unfortunately, because shark skeletons are made up of cartilage, which quickly disintegrates in seawater, only teeth survive a Megalodon's death. So the odds of finding teeth from modern Megalodons lurking in extremely deep water are astronomically low. Yet, eyewitness accounts describing giant sharks abound throughout human history, and while most are likely nothing more than tall tales or fish stories, the sheer number of them begs the suggestion that there may be some truth to them. In 1918, Australian naturalist David Steed recorded that a group of local fishermen refused to go back out to sea after encountering a shark of incredible proportions. Per Steed's notes, the fishermen of Port Stephens reported working at their fishing grounds in deep water, when suddenly an enormous ghostly white shark rose from the depths and attacked their crayfish pots, devouring the 3-foot 6-inch pots and crayfish inside whole. The giant shark destroyed their tackle, and the men returned to port raving about a 100-foot shark, refusing to go back to sea for several days. While Steed notes that the measurement was obviously impossible, he does go on to say that he was familiar with the fishermen for many years, and that they were stolid men, not given to fish stories, nor even talking about their catches. Mr. Steed also notes that all the fishermen involved were experienced men well used to sighting whales, and even great whites, yet the men were in a state of outright fear and panic upon returning to shore. This would not be the only sighting of a possible megalodon off the coasts of Australia, with the crew of a fishing vessel in the 1960s reporting their own encounter with a giant shark. Initially reluctant to speak about it for fear of being teased, they, along with their captain, admitted to seeing a gargantuan white shark swim past their 85-foot boat, claiming that it rivaled their own ship in size. All men involved were familiar with whales and steadfastly denied the creature being a whale. Though most telling of all may possibly be the fact that this giant shark's skin so closely matched the ghostly white complexion of the 1918 sighting. Sightings of giant sharks have been reported across the Pacific and as far east as the Mexican coast. While fear of the water can certainly play tricks on the mind, before you dismiss any of these claims of megalodon's existence, it's important to remember that only until recently did modern science accept the existence of squids large enough to eat men, and only 6 years ago was one finally caught on tape. Whether you believe Megalodon is real or not is up to you, but when it comes to information about who you should use to build and host your new website, you have to trust us. Our suggestion, of course, is Wix. Wix is a powerful and awesome platform for anybody, whether you're a complete beginner, a business owner, a professional designer, or even a professional website builder. Regardless of what exactly your business or hobby is, one thing's for sure, Wix has a professional solution for it. And if you're looking for more than just a website, maybe email marketing, a mailbox, or a custom domain, Wix can help you with that as well. Don't worry whether Megalodon is real or not. Worry about that website you don't have yet. Go to wix.com/go/infographics or click the link in the description and build the website you want and need today. Could Megalodon still lurk in the deepest depths, having learned to hunt large prey in the abyss? Have you ever seen anything strange in the ocean? Let us know in the comments. Also, be sure to check out our other video called Horrible Things That Will Happen in 2019. Thanks for watching, and as always, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. See you next time!